Now to an I-Team investigation. Taxpayers subsidizing rent for people making six-figure salaries?
As I-Team reporter Ryan Kath discovered, public housing leaders know that this is happening, but they don't think it's a problem.
Like thousands of other low-income residents, Angelina DePina knows how tough it is to find an affordable place to live.
The wait lists, you know, for some of these programs are 10 years long.
To qualify, you can only make a certain amount of money.
Here's what they're making.
Oh, wow.
So the Dorchester working mom was surprised when we showed her hundreds of families around the state are earning well above those limits.
I think it's a smack in the face, honestly. It's just really disgusting because there truly are individuals who are really struggling.
At Orchard Gardens in Roxbury, one family of four reported $228,000 of income. And at this housing development in Mission Hill, five different families bring in six figures.
What it boils down to is it fair? And it's no, it's not fair.
But nobody is telling them to pack up and leave. In this scathing report, the federal inspector general revealed more than 25,000 families across the country are now over income.
Why should people making that much money continue to live in taxpayer subsidized housing?
They're helping support the taxpayer subsidized housing by paying the rents that they're paying.
Lydia Agro of the Boston Housing Authority says overincome residents pay the highest rent amounts at a time when federal funds are strapped. And while high-income families only make up a small percentage of the housing population, administrators believe they serve as good role models.
We don't want to create communities where all of our resident population is very low income and there are no working families.
The I-Team reviewed public housing records and found some eye-popping dollar amounts all over the state. Tenants making more than double the income limits in places like Lynn, New Bedford, Somerville, and Worcester.
And here in Cambridge, the highest earning family makes $200,000 per year. That family of six bringing in four different salaries, all while paying just $1,700 per month.
People with excess income shouldn't be in subsidized housing.
Massachusetts Congressman Mike Capuano doesn't believe people should get kicked out the moment they go a dollar over the limit.
But if you go over by $100,000, I would argue that give yourself 30, 60, 90 days, pick some reasonable time frame, say, good for you, it worked, move on.
And open up a spot for someone else.
I mean, the system that they have is definitely flawed and it needs to be readjusted.
Some housing authorities told the I-Team they're waiting for federal guidance on when and how they should evict overincome residents. Others, like Boston, are already in the process of writing a new policy. For the I-Team, Ryan Kath, WBZ News.